Welcome back, Pokefans, to Pokemon Shining Pearl walkthrough part 25. Last episode, we went to Whalestone HQ and defeated Cyrus as well as Saturn. We also went ahead and released the three legendary Pokemons. This episode, just like Cyrus said before, we will be actually going to Mount Coronet Summit. We will be trying to actually stop Cyrus from destroying this world. Alright, so now I'm in Route 207. I've actually gone ahead and caught a Snorunt in undergrounds. This you will be only able to find when you go to Snowpoint City and go to underground from there. I've also gone ahead and caught a few other Pokemons as well. The first one is going to be a Glalie and the second one is going to be a Mr. Mime. So both of them, I did find them in the Ice Cave and the Whiteout Cave in undergrounds. Now I do want to actually let you guys know that I'm actually going to be using Frostlass as the last Pokemon in my team. The main reason for this would be I've never used an ice type Pokemon in my team before, so I'm quite excited to use this. Frostlass is also going to be quite helpful as she is part ghost and ice type. It's quite a unique dual type Pokemon and I'm really excited to use it. I've also gone ahead and changed my style. I bought the spring style from Whalestone City. Now let me just go ahead and run away from this battle. I really don't want to catch another Chingling. Before you come to here, please make sure that you have bought a lot of healing items, potions as well as ripples, because you don't get healed in between this whole. Now let me just climb up over here and go through the stairs. I would also recommend that you guys bring a lot of Ultra Balls or Timer Balls. You will be able to bind them in any of the Pokemarts. You will actually be catching the legendary Pokemon over here. So I would really recommend that you buy stuff and save your game. For now, let me go ahead and go through over here. First of all, you get a Max Potion right over here. There is also another hidden item. And okay. So yeah, let me go ahead and talk about the encounters. So you only have one new encounter over here and it's actually going to be this Bronzong. So now that I've actually encountered it, let me just go ahead and catch it. Alright, so Bronzong is a really good Pokemon. It's actually a steel and psychic type. If you want to have a really good defensive type Pokemon, you can actually go ahead and catch this. Alright, so we don't really have any other new encounters soon. So let me just go ahead. Alright, so as I was saying before, we do have a hidden item right over here and it's going to be an Aether. Let me go ahead and come down. We have another item right below. So over here we will be getting an escape rope. Alright, so over here we do have a lot of items to pick up. There are a lot of hidden items as well as some other items. First of all, let me just go down over here. If you come out of this entrance, it will actually go to Route 207. You might remember that we did see a rock climb right over here. So we can finally go ahead and pick up this one item. And there we go. So this item is gonna be an iron. Again, a really good item, quite useful. Now let me go ahead and climb back and go to the cave. All we have to do is actually go north to move on. We need to just cross this, come down, and right down over here we did see a Pokeball item. It's going to be Rock Slide. Okay, so this is also a really good TM. Quite useful against most of the Pokemons. So you can always teach it. The very next item is going to be a Revive. It's right over here. Alright. Now we can go ahead and move on. I don't think we have any more items in this cave. If you go down the ledges over there, it will actually go to the entrance of the cave. So in case if you want to heal, you can go through that way. Now this cave over here, let me go ahead and actually go to the right side. We actually have an item right over there as well, and it's going to be a hidden item. So over here you will be getting a max revive. Alright, so now that we have picked up all the items, we can actually go ahead and go to the north. We also have another Team Galactic member right over here. She's going to be only having one Pokemon and she's going to be having a Beautifly. So let me just go ahead and quickly defeat her. I've also gone ahead and placed my Snorunt in the beginning of my team. It is currently at level 42, but I do want to have it at level 48 before we actually go ahead and battle the Team Galactic commanders as well as Cyrus. Now that we have defeated this grunt, I do actually want to evolve my Snorunt. I already have a Dawnstone, so let me just go ahead and use it. So actually I did find this Dawnstone with the help of my Ponchorisu. I was running around in Iron Islands and my Ponchorisu actually picked up a Dawnstone. This was quite lucky, or else I don't think I would have been able to evolve it right away. Alright, so finally we have a Froslass. This is really cool. Now Froslass can actually make more damage than my Snorunt. Now let me go ahead and actually teach it Hex, as it is quite useful on my Froslass. I would also recommend that you guys go underground in Snowpoint City, as in one of the caves you will be able to find a leftover. Now I have also gone ahead and equipped it to my Froslass. Alright, so now actually that Froslass is more stronger, we can actually go ahead and use it. I do want it to be around level 48. So let's see if we can do it. Alright, so there is only one hidden item in this cave and it's right over here. So you will be able to find a Super Ripple right here. Let me also go ahead and battle this grunt as well. He will also be having only one Pokemon and it's gonna be a Bronzor. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. Alright, now we can actually go ahead. There are no more grunts in this cave. Let me go ahead and go to the exit. And we'll actually be coming to a snowy area. Again, we don't really have any new encounters right here as well. So I've just gone ahead and put up a ripple. I don't really want to encounter any Pokemon currently. Now that is due to all the Pokemons over here being around level 40 and they're quite difficult to defeat. Let me go ahead and use Rock Climb again. We will be able to find another item. If you come to the right over here, you will be able to find another hidden item. You just have to click near the rock and you will be able to find a nugget. Now let me go back. I did see another cave entrance, but I don't want to go through there. I want to actually explore the snowy area before we go through that entrance. Now I don't think we actually need to move this boulder unless you want to avoid all the Pokemons in the grass above. But let me just go ahead and move this stone or rock, and if you come right here and use Rock Smash, you will actually be able to find another hidden item. I see that most of these routes have a lot of hidden items, so it's really nice, you can always pick it up. Now here you will be able to find a max potion. The game is of course trying to be really generous at this point, as they know that we have a lot of trainers to battle. Now before going to that other cave entrance, let me just go ahead and rock climb over here. I think this is the correct way that we're actually supposed to go through. And let me just defeat this trainer. We can just go back to that entrance again and pick up the items from there before we move on from here. Now this Galactic Grunt is going to be having 3 Pokemons. He's going to be having 2 Dustox and a Golbat. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. Alright, so now that I have defeated him, let me just go ahead and actually go back to that other cave. And we can see what items we'll get over there. And here we are. Let me go ahead and go inside. We actually have 2 items right over here. The first one is an Ultra Ball. It is another hidden item. And the second one is right down over here. You have to just break these rocks and you will be able to find it as well. So this is also gonna be another hidden item. There is another item, but you do need the waterfalls to actually get it. So now that I'm back in the other cave, you will be able to find an ether right over here, and we can move on. Over here, we do have another Galactic Grunt. Now he's gonna be having two Pokemons, a Stunky as well as a Golbat. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. Now that I have defeated him, let me just go ahead and pick up the very last item in this cave. I think it's also gonna be another hidden item, and it's gonna be an escape rope. Alright, let's go ahead and go out of this cave. We still have some distance to actually reach Cyrus and the Team Galactic members or commanders. So let me just go ahead. We do have a few hidden items here as well. First of all, we have a cave entrance over here. Let me not go ahead and go into it right away. I do want to actually explore before we actually come over here. Now, at this point, I just didn't know that it was a dead end, so I just went ahead and explored the other places. Now, the very first item, you have to actually just rock climb over here, and you will be able to find it next to this rock. It's going to be another red candy, a very useful item as well. Now, let me just go back and go down, and let me rock climb the other way. So over here, you just have to go ahead and go down. We do have a few items. You can either actually move this strength rock right here, or you can just go ahead and go down the stairs. Now I did realize that we can go through the stairs, and you will actually be able to find another hidden item right over here, and it's gonna be a tiny mushroom. And there's actually an item in the very bottom right over here, and it's gonna be a big mushroom. Now that we have actually picked up all the items, let me just go ahead and go to this other cave, this entrance right over here, and we will be able to find only one item, and it's gonna be right here, and it's gonna be another tiny mushroom. Now before I continue this way, I do want to go through the other cave entrance, because this is actually the correct way that we're actually supposed to go through. So let me just cut away and go over there. Alright, now over here you do have a few Team Galactic Grunts, so let me just go ahead and actually battle all of them. The very first one is right over here. Now he only has one Pokemon, and he's gonna be just having a Golbat. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. I feel that leftovers from my Frostlass is really working pretty well. It helps it hold its health as well as defeat the opponents. Now let me just go ahead and use rock climb right here. We do have a few items over here as well. The very first one is gonna be right at the top. As you might have guessed, it's right next to this rock. It's going to be a big mushroom. The very next one is actually going to be in this lane. You have to just break these rocks and you will be able to find it. Here we go. So here we have another Max Ether. Now let me just go ahead and battle this Team Galactic Grunt before we move on. Now this Grunt will have three Pokemons. She is going to be having a Wurmple, Beautifly as well as a Silcoon. So let me just go ahead and defeat her. She's gonna be pretty easy. Now I do see that my Pokemons are quite not yet at the level 48. I do want them to all be there at that level. Otherwise it's gonna be a little bit tricky to actually defeat them. For now, let me just go ahead and defeat this Grunt as well. He's gonna be having three Pokemons. Now he has two Croagunks and a Stunky. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. Alright, now that we have defeated him, we can go on. Now I have also put up a ripple. We don't really have any new encounters in this cave as well, so we can just go ahead. The very next item you will be able to just get it once you do the rock smash right here, and it's gonna be a full restore. All of these items are gonna be really useful for us during the battle. You will find another item right over here, and it's gonna be a nugget. Let me use rock climb over here and go down. So almost all the items that we are seeing till now have been kind of hidden items. We also have one more item right here. All we have to do is break this rock as well, and we'll be able to pick it up. This is gonna be a rare candy. Alright, some really good items. Now before we move on this way, I do want to actually go back the other way around as well. But before that, we do get another revive right over here. Quite a lot of items, I must say. I think it's around 5 to 6 items in this cave itself. Now if you come down here, you will see that there is a grunt blocking away. So this cave is actually going to be connecting to the Mount Coronet North that we actually passed through to go to Snow Pond City. Now let me just go ahead and use the rock climb over here and climb up over here as well, and I'll be seeing you guys soon in the other cave. Alright, so here we are. We do have two Team Galactic grunts in this cave, so let me just go ahead and defeat them as well. Now this grunt over here is gonna be having two Pokemons. She's gonna be having a Bronzor as well as Glamia. Let me go ahead and defeat her. Now I do want to talk about the new encounter in this cave. So if you're really lucky, there is a very small chance of actually finding a Chimecho in this cave. It is really rare. I would recommend actually catching it in the very next cave rather than this one. Now over here you will be able to find two items, a max potion as well as a bag of stardust. Now let me just go ahead and battle this Team Galactic grunt. He's gonna be having two Pokemons. Now he has a Bronzor as well as a Golbat. So let me just go ahead and defeat him. Alright, that was pretty easy. All of my Pokemons are around level 46 to 47 currently. I am hoping that they will be level 48 before we battle Cyrus. Over here, we only have one grunt, and we can just go ahead and battle her. She is going to be having a Golbat, Glamia, and a Bronzor. So let me just go ahead and defeat her. Now that we have defeated her, let me just go ahead and move on. I've also tried actually to find that rare Pokemon, Chimecho, in this cave, but unfortunately I was not able to find it. So let me just go ahead and move on for now, and we can actually catch it in a later stage. For now, let me just go ahead and go out this exit. Now you might see that we do have a double battle coming up. So let me just go ahead and battle these two before I go back and actually heal my Pokemons. Now the left grunt will be having a Stunky as well as a Glamia, whereas the right grunt will actually have a Dustox as well as a Croagunk. So let me just go ahead and defeat them. Alright, so now that we have defeated all the Team Galactic grunts, let me just go ahead and go back to Auburg City and heal my Pokemons. I'll be back very fast. I do want to actually make sure all of my Pokemon are fully healed, and then we can go ahead and battle the Team Galactic commanders. Alright, so here we go. Now all will end and everything will begin. With this red chain, I will pray open the portal to another dimension. I command that you unleash your power for me. Palkia, the mythical Pokemon and the master of space and dimensions. Now we'll actually go ahead and keep quiet so that this whole cutscene can go through. I don't really want to interrupt in between. Thank you. This will bring about the destruction of all things. With everything gone, there will be no fighting and no strife. Feel the dimension distorting. Only I can stop it. This is the mythical Pokemon that created Sinnoh. Palkia, the ancient deity of space and dimensions. This world cannot be molded into the ultimate world I seek. It's far easier to create entirely a new world than to change this one. A new world in which I am a ruler of all things. I shall become a deity. Alright, so now we are actually gonna be battling both Mars as well as Jupiter. There's no need to rush. I can understand you want to battle our boss real bad. But you'll have to battle me. And I'll be next. You might be tough, but this time the gloves are coming off. Hold on one sec. Don't you start the party without me. Alright, as you can see, we'll actually be having a double battle with the Berry against Jupiter and Mars. So let us go ahead and actually win this one. They both are going to be having 3 Pokemons each, and their first Pokemon is going to be a Bronzor. Now I do have my Frostlass in the beginning of my team. I'm hoping that my Frostlass will be able to actually defeat at least one of their Bronzors. Both the Bronzors are going to be at level 41. They are at quite a good level. Let me go ahead and actually use Hex. Oh, okay. That Bronzor barely lived. I was hoping to one-shot it, but I guess not. Now, they've actually gone ahead and set up a Life Screen as well as a Reflect, which is 2 really good moves. It's going to be a little bit difficult to actually destroy them now. Let me go ahead and use Hex again. This time I'm just going ahead and using Hex on the next one. As you can see, that did very less damage than before, so this is gonna be quite challenging. Alright, so the Munchlax is actually confused. I'm hoping it will actually be able to at least hit once at least. That payback didn't do that much. Let me just go ahead and use Hex again. Alright, Munchlax hit itself. I'm kind of worried about this. If Munchlax isn't able to actually hit the opponent, it will be quite difficult for me as well. Let me go ahead and defeat this Bronzor. We only have one. I'm hoping that Munchlax will be able to actually take down the other Bronzor. After all, it's just hanging up in, I think, 2-3 HPs. The payback isn't doing that much, so I guess I can still keep Frostlass up in front. Yes, so Munchlax was able to actually hit it right here, and we have defeated both the Bronzors. As you might see, all of my Pokemons are around level 48 now. Only Frostlass as well as my Houndoom are at level 47. Okay, so she has brought out her Skuntank. Okay, her Skuntank is actually gonna be at level 46, which is quite near to my level. As well as her Golbat is gonna be at level 42. Now, I did make a mistake over here using Ice Fang for the Golbat. I wish I had actually switched out my Frostlass. This Skuntank does have Flamethrower and I'm quite worried. Alright, I guess that's all for my Frostlass. I should have actually switched it out. Anyway, let me go ahead and bring out some other Pokemon. I will have to bring out a Pokemon that is going to be resisting the Flamethrower. Alright, I think Pippin is the best one right here. I don't want to bring out my Togekiss or other Pokemons currently. I do think that Pippin's Bubble Beam will be a lot of damage. But for now, they actually still have the Light Screen as well as Reflect still on, so once that wears off, we'll be easily able to defeat them. Alright, so Skuntank's flamethrower is not gonna be doing that much damage on us. And yes, Munchlax is gonna be using a body slam. And it paralyzed the Skuntank. That is a really good move. Also, both Reflect as well as Light Screen have worn off, so we will be easily able to defeat them. Now, Skuntank will be holding a Citrus Berry, so it's quite tricky to actually defeat it. You might see it here, it is actually eating its berry. But it's not gonna be an issue, we will be able to actually defeat it in the next turn. Over here, let me see if the Munchlax will be able to just defeat the Golbat. And yes, there we go. Alright, so now I think the next Pokemon is gonna be her Paragly. But that's okay. I can still keep my Pippin outside. Now Paragly is gonna be at level 45. And it would be really helpful if you have a fighting type Pokemon for this battle. I did go ahead and use a revive over here on my Froslass. I don't want it to actually lose out on this EXP. Alright, so Paragly did use Dig and I'm quite worried that Pippin might go down right here. But I really can't switch out to any of my Pokemon, so I guess I'll just go ahead and use another Bubble Beam and hope that Paragly won't be able to defeat me. Ooh, that was close, but yes. Thankfully, my Pippin was able to hold on. And let us see if we can defeat this Skuntank right here. Yes, the Skuntank is down. Alright, that is really good. And now Munchlax will be able to use Body Slam. And it paralyzed the Paragly as well. This is a really good thing. Alright, so over here is another Golbat. Now, let me just go ahead and actually switch out my team. I don't really want to have my Pippin out there anymore. Let me go ahead and bring out my Ponchorisu. It should be able to take down the Golbat. Alright, this is a really good turn. Paragly was paralyzed. Now over here Paragly will also be holding a Citrus Berry, as you saw it has used it. Let me go ahead and use Thunderbolt on the Golbat and see how much damage we do. Almost down, I think one more move should take it out. Thankfully over here my Ponchorisu did dodge the Sludge Bomb, that was a really good thing. All I'm hoping is that the Paragly does not use Dig. Let me go ahead and take down the Golbat. Yes, there we go. Now for the Paragly's Dig. Yes, so Paragly was paralyzed, so we are actually able to defeat it right here. I guess we need one more move. Let me just go ahead and use Discharge. I don't really mind about the Munchlax. It won't go down for it. Yes, there we go. Alright, so we have gone ahead and defeated both Mars as well as Jupiter. Sheesh, I should have done the fighting myself. You've toughened up, but you're no match for our boss. Alright, so hey, my Pokemon are tough, right? But you know, that's it for us. We have hit the wall. Dash, I'll help you with this. Alright, so he has actually healed our Pokemon. Thank you so much, Berry. And we are actually gonna be battling Cyrus right over here. Oh, Palkia, this is... Fantastic, beautiful. It's the creation of a new galaxy, my new world. Whoa, what? Alright, so they have gone ahead and saved Palkia. I guess that's the end of Cyrus's world. Alright. The red team, it crumbled away to nothing. But why? Why would Mesprit, the Pokemon of Lake Verity, appear by your side? But never mind that, it's all destroyed. My galaxy is gone. I won't allow this. I will capture those three again and craft another red chain. But before I even think about that, I'm going to completely crush you. Alright, so this is where we're actually going to be battling Cyrus. And here we go. I am really nervous for this battle. He has some really good Pokemons. His very first Pokemon is gonna be Hunscrow. Now over here we actually can't switch up our team members, so I still have my Frostlass in the beginning. Let me go ahead and actually switch up to Ponchirisu. Alright. I've also gone ahead and actually used some more stickers on my ball decorations. And over here it did get a critical hit. So let me just go ahead and heal my Ponchirisu. I don't think any of my other Pokemons can actually deal with this Hunscrow as much as my Ponchirisu can. And hope we don't get crit again. Now, let's see. What? Again? Seriously? Alright, let me just go ahead and heal it again. And see if it will get crit up again. I don't want it to crit the Night Slash again. This is ridiculous. It's already crit twice. Well, it crit again. Actually, this Hunscrow does have super luck as its ability, so it will be able to give a high chance of crit. Thankfully, over here, my Ponchirisu landed a crit hit, so it was able to take down the Hunscrow. This is really nice. That was a really good payback to the Hunscrow. I'm so happy. Now, let us see which Pokemon he's gonna be bringing out. Over here, Ponchirisu did want to learn Thunder, so I just went ahead and removed Discharge. We can have Thunder, that is a better move. And he's gonna be bringing out his Gyarados, okay. Now, Gyarados is gonna be giving an Intimidate immediately, but I don't think that matters since I'm gonna be using Thunderbolt. Oh, so actually this Gyarados is gonna be having a Vecon Berry, so that will actually decrease the super effectiveness of my move. So that's the reason why Gyarados was able to stand up, and it used Earthquake. So I guess we have to bring out some other Pokemon. Let me go ahead and actually bring out my Togekiss. It's the only Pokemon that I can actually bring out at this point. I was really worried at this point because all of my team members are really weak to ground type moves. I don't really have anyone that resists it other than Togekiss. I guess I have to just bring it out at this point. Alright, so Togekiss does have Air Slash, so I'm hoping that it will be able to crit it. Let me see how much damage this Air Slash does. Oof, it almost took it down, but at least it flinched the Gyarados. Now over here, Cyrus did go ahead and use a Full Restore, but that's alright. I should be able to take down this Gyarados in another 2 moves. Let me just go ahead and keep on using Air Slash until this Gyarados goes down. Over here, Gyarados did go ahead and use Ice Fang. Thankfully, it did not freeze my Togekiss. And I can just go ahead and use another Air Slash. He did heal with the Super Potion, but I think I can just take down the Gyarados with one Air Slash right over here. Yes, there we go. So that's his second Pokemon. Now, let us see what other Pokemon he's gonna be bringing out. Now, he is gonna be bringing out his Crobat right here. I'm not gonna be switching out my Togekiss. I actually have to revive my Ponchorisu before I can actually switch out. So let me just go ahead and do that. I'm just hoping that Togekiss can take one cross poison at least. Yes. Alright, so now I think I can just go ahead and switch out to Pippin as he resists the cross poison. Now his Golbat actually holds a Quick Lock. So you can see that it did activate right over there. But since I'm switching out, he won't be faster than me. And the cross poison doesn't do any damage. That's a good thing. Now let me just go ahead and actually heal my Ponchorisu. I'll just go ahead and actually use a Moo Moo Mill. Over here, the Crobat again got the Quick Claw activated second time in a row, which is really rare. It did go ahead and use Tailwind, which is okay. Now that my Ponchorisu is completely healed, I can go ahead and actually switch it out. This is the third time the Quick Claw is activating for Crobat. Really, this is ridiculous at this point. I mean, three times in a row, seriously. Anyway, it did use Air Cutter for some reason, and you know, it is my Ponchorisu is gonna be resisting it. Let me go ahead and actually try using Thunder and see how much damage it does. Now, I did want to mention about the background for this battle. It looks really nice. The galaxy also really looks so good. I mean, this theme is really nice. Alright, so now over here, I have gone ahead and used Thunderbolt. Thankfully, my Ponchorisu was able to hold up in 10 HP and actually take down this Crobat. It is quite lucky for us that it was not able to crit at this point. Anyway, now it's only gonna be his last Pokemon and it's gonna be a Weavile. So let me just go ahead and switch out to my Houndoom. It should be easily able to take down the Weavile. Now I did forget that his Weavile has Dig for some reason, and yeah, I shouldn't have bought out my Houndoom. Anyway, you will see that he is gonna be using Dig, and since Weavile is gonna be faster than my Houndoom, it's gonna be going underground. I know my Houndoom cannot take out a Dig, so let me just go ahead and switch out. I'll go ahead and go to my Togekiss for now. I guess you can say that my Togekiss is kind of saving my team members at this point. Now, let me just go ahead and actually use Roost so that I can heal up my Togekiss. It's a good thing I have this move. It should be able to actually fully heal my Togekiss. Alright, so it's almost healed. That's okay. Now let me just go ahead and actually use Air Slash again. I guess that's the only move that does good damage. Alright, so we should be able to actually take down this Weavile in the next move. It's a really good thing I actually evolved my Togetic. Togekiss has been a really good savior for me for the last few battles. Now, over here, Weavile did go ahead and crit me, but I still was able to hang on and hit it. And we're finally able to actually destroy Cyrus. Awesome. Alright, so all of my Pokemon are around level 49 and 50. I won't accept this. The power spoken in mythology. I didn't just make it obey me. I made it my own. Alright. What is truly the ultimate to you? What do you consider perfection? The most beautiful thing. The joy that shines the brightest. Telling you is meaningless. But I will not give up. I will become a deity one day. And I will make the ultimate mine. Alright, so we have gone ahead and actually defeated all of the Team Galactic members. And here comes both Lucas as well as Professor Rowan. Valkia, the master of space and dimension. It's impossible to tell if it's enraged or saddened. But to me, Valkia appears to be waiting for you, Dash. It seems to be challenging you as a test. Go on, Dash, face up to Valkia. Listen to its heart, understand its thoughts. Valkia is out of control after being dragged out by the red chain and forced to use its power. Valkia seems to be trusting you to stop it. Dash, I just ran into Barry. He said that he believed in you. He said you could get the job done. I think so too. You've got to help that Pokemon. It's suffering from being dragged out by Team Galactic. Alright, so this is where you will actually get a chance to save your game before you go ahead and actually talk to the Pokemon. Let me just go ahead and actually heal up my Pokemons before we can go forward. Alright, so I'm actually ready to face up Valkia. This is the place you will actually be able to catch it. You can always go ahead and use your Master Ball that you have already got from Cyrus. But I just want to try and use the Ultra Balls that I have bought. Valkia is going to be having Pressure as its ability. And it's going to be having Slash, Ancient Power, Aqua Ring and Spatial Ring. So if you have a Fairy type Pokemon, you can just bring it out. Valkia is after all a Dragon as well as a Water type. Now I'm just going ahead and using Will-O-Wisp right here. I just want to make sure that I have something counteracting that Aqua Ring. After all, it's gonna be actually getting some HP back after each turn. Now it did go ahead and use Ancient Power right here. I really don't want to keep my Frostlass in the beginning. It has already fainted a lot of time. So let me just go ahead and actually switch it out. And I'll just go ahead and bring out my Rosa. She should be able to resist it. Alright, so I'm actually ready to go ahead and start throwing Ultra Balls at it. Hope that it will be able to actually not destroy my team. And hope I'll be able to soon catch it. As you can see, the burn is doing quite a lot of good damage as soon as the Aqua Ring heals it. So that is one good thing. I did go ahead and use Sludge Bomb. I thought that I should just go ahead and damage it a little bit. But I don't think Sludge Bomb is gonna be enough. Let me go ahead and actually use another move to damage it. I do want to see how much HP I can bring it down to before I can start checking the Ultra Balls. I did go ahead and use Grass Knot right here. I'm hoping it doesn't one-shot it. Perfect. Alright, so Valkia is finally down to red. I think this is a good health to actually start out checking my Pokeballs. I've bought around 30 Ultra Balls and I'm hoping I will be able to catch it within this. If not, I can just go ahead and actually restart my game and try catching it again. Alright, there goes down Rosa. Let me just go ahead and switch out to my another Pokemon. I will also go ahead and cut out to the part where I've actually gone ahead and caught it. I think it took me around 10 to 15 minutes to actually catch it. Alright, I'm pretty much down to my last few Ultra Balls. 1, 2, 3. Yes. Finally, I was able to catch Valkia. I was a bit worried that I might run out of my Ultra Balls and I might have to reset my game. But that's not needed. I was able to catch it. Alright, so Palkia's data is in my Pokedex. And let me just send it to my box. Half of my team are kind of down, but yeah. So this is Palkia. Let me just go ahead and actually show its Pokedex entry as well as the moves. I'm not gonna be using this, so I don't really mind. Anyway, let me just go ahead and go back. I do have still one Pokemon to catch. It's gonna be that Chimecho. So let me just try and see if I'll be actually able to catch it. But before that, Dash, I don't know how you were magnificent. Truly, you were incredible. I've lived for 60 years, but I've never been thrilled like this. Since the last time, the professor did a lot of research. He became very worried about you, Dash, so he came out to a place as terrible as this. Dash, I'm glad to see you're safe. Let's leave this place immediately. Alright. No one has the right to take away anyone's future or anyone's world. That is true. So now, before we actually leave, we need to go back because we will be getting the item right here. So we are going to be getting a Lustrous Orb. This is a really good health item for your Palkia, so you can just go ahead and equip it in case if you're using Palkia in your team. Now let me just go ahead and cut around to the time where I'll actually be able to find that Chimecho, and we can go ahead and catch it as well. Alright, so finally I was able to find Chimecho. I think it took me around 30 minutes to find it. Anyway, let me just go ahead and catch it. So Chimecho is a psychic type Pokemon. You will be able to actually evolve it with the help of your Chingling if your Chingling has high friendship level and you actually try to evolve it at night time. But if you have any issues doing that, you can just go ahead and actually catch a Chimecho directly over here. Now you will be only able to find it in two caves. One is the fifth one and the second one is the sixth floor. In the fifth floor, it's quite rare. It's very rare. Whereas in the sixth floor, it's only rare. So it has more chance of actually encountering it. Now that we have completed everything, let me just go ahead and go back to, I think, Pastoria City, because that's where we have to go next. Now, you may remember that there was a cave entrance that was being blocked by a Team Galactic member last time. Now he's actually gone. You will be able to pick up the TM for Dragon Claw right over here. A really good move, and I would actually recommend that you guys come over here. Now I have actually decided to end the video right over here. In the next episode, we will travel to Sunny Shore City. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching my videos. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. And I'll be seeing you guys in the next one.